que je parlais de la licence suicide des témoins. Same. Houston. He's called a stenographer, medical stenographer, dermatologist. We have a certainty of how the climate, not just the climate, but the pH is like you want it. Climate's up there. Another thing, the environment has changed. Everybody else, why would the mechanism? And we have more or less like predictions. But it's about CO2 that we are exceeding the worst case scenario possible. But the work is done. That is almost certain, which is something that many things are almost certain. Is it certainly possible that biological responses may be coming because they have information from climate physicists and chemists? We actually have no point to test. These changes in the air suppressive model are refined, and the global model are relevant for regional testing, which we do. But ideally, at least the things that are fascinating the most is an incredible diversity of degrees, not just consider animals and so on. Just the dream to be optimal, the best possible, to increase your chance of survival. which some would mention as some very special ecosystem function. And it's really interesting. I'm really intrigued by this. And probably there's another one. Whatever we choose, which is the best. So how about, I'll play a quote again. I started my fellowship in Linux in 2008. For 5 years, people came out of it. It was similar to the other one in Canada, which they used. At the end, I had a permanent job. For sure, that's all I needed. And then I started asking questions. And so I'll go through these setting this sort of review. Okay, we'll see how much time I might have to cut one if we don't have the time. Particularly as you believe me, I'm making an effort to speak slowly. It was as easy as I can. So the first question, because I'm not the one in the last place, only the one studying, I decided to go to the Central Bank of Israel. It's an amazing place. It's very, it's actually, it's a strong connection of Naples with Spain, because it was a kingdom that lasted for 2 centuries and a half. It was Spain, but I don't know where you got it. It's day of but the idea is that it was great because you have a national system where you have volcanic activity, where seabed, yeah, bubbles CO2. They release CO2 into the water and acidify it to a level that is actually not representative of the CO2 is forced. Yes. I can leave it in the presentation if you have one more and the idea is that it's only CO2, there's no other toxin like sulfur or other metals present. It's only traces in the same level in the regular ocean. Different from other CO2, they have heavy metals, sulfur. So the other level, when you see through some of the toxicity of the product. What is interesting is that we can actually do in situ treatment. Because until then, for 3 years, we're trying to find a model to make it better. And a field immediately for 3 years to make it work. A kind of culture to offer a new generation of the world. So here we went to get these species that have been there for 2,000 years. Right now, I think it's Canadian. Actually told when there was an eruption that caused some field beds to create, and it seemed to serve a lot of us concerns. He also had gathered with some of my students and some of my people. To look at dating how frequent and continuous this sort of work has been. Let's say, let's assume it was 2014. Well, we didn't actually focus on related work, we were not classifiers. In this way, we just couldn't say whether the complication and classification was just their metabolism. We wanted to see whether they could adapt to evolve their metabolism and the ICO population. And there were 7 species, but this one in particular that gave us the most interesting result. There's some potentially physiological adaptation, I'll show you a second. So what we notice, especially metabolic rates, here on the graph on the y-axis, expression rates as a way to measure metabolism. We notice that the control here, it is very similar, the control to control is very similar rate to the control to C5, so they might change the liquid buffer. They have some ability in the short-term experiment, 5 days, to buffer the metabolism. And so there's no significant reaction, no, which we actually find when we actually expose individuals to changing condition from acidified acidified to acidified that goes to the control. So once we remove the stress from CO2, we tend to lower metabolism, to slow down metabolism, we have a significant increase. But the most important thing is not just the reaction mode, there is one here, here, and it's not here. So the level is also different. Those are two signs of adaptation. The specimen of populations and population inside the vent is adapted, long-term acclimated, to have a higher level of metabolism. And again, possibly to compensate this reduction in aerobic capacity the CO2 tend to cause in infection. So we went to look for a genetic signature. We don't have a genome, we didn't have genomic tool at the time that we developed since then. And we look at the genetic structure. The population that is inside from the control area, the yellow one, is similar to the population there on the other side of the island, on the Comodo Valley Peninsula, on the south of the Peninsula. species in the family within the Cetomeranthus species, which actually is called Basiliensis, which is over in France, found 5-6 times in Nigeria, 1-20 in Italy, and they're super rare. It's actually 12-1 in the context of the inside Cetomeranthus. So maybe it evolved there, maybe it's initiated there. But for sure, it does better there than the other species. It gets an edge in the region. What is interesting is that it actually evolved a different system of reproduction. The domain would actually like it. Sorry, I'm going to take one because these volunteers are exposure would have different responses. And we actually exceeded our expectations. So we can valuable points in under condition of 50 degrees, which is a temperature relatively common in air and in water for the whole population, saving water for total of the air that we experience here. We kept them under water though for something that was very stable, and then we measure, we kept them in this experimental system for 2 weeks.
And you can see here the relation between latitudes and where they come from, and the inventory rates. So I don't think they're the most important.
And what is interesting is that we're from here, you can see that here, there's a relationship between the total sense of conditions and not the age. And the increase should
have seen the term adaptation. That's why it was like 90%. It's the first time I was accused that nobody was real. And the answer to the viewers was saying that we were lying. Like, but the thing is, that he's more just he's a product of an average of 120 people. We might be far from this. We wanted this. And to increase, actually, the conservatism or estimate, in group of 30, in group of 20, we tested him in area, the fact has been once again for the metabolic range of 5 different temperatures. So that we stretch the variance as much as possible. We wanted it to be conserved. Because the experience is very tempting. And even with that, we saw this.
So then the expectation was, is that the slope increasing to change? Is the elevation going to change? Or
is it going to transform? The we found it going to change in slope and elevation. Not transform like this. But in an AIC analysis, where we did that here, that's a different regression from either the best likelihood of regression, and this is the most important by far.
But we have that the
variance from this is important. Yeah, the southern population conform to a certain phenotype, but they both reduce potassium. It's not metabolic depression, it's reduction. Depression is a mechanism like hibernation. You go to a lab and you say, this is just the effect of temperature under stress, it's a symptom. So here, when exposed to ICO2, the central population regulate the metabolism to increase the capacity for energy production to try to compensate and regulate potentially. And then we have, in the north, we don't see anything change. Now, I don't have the time to show you, we also did metabolic things on this. And we showed what happened. And they put a lot of effort into changing the metabolic. They put a lot of effort keeping it together. They slowed down to maintain it. Because they shut down, like my soul did during low time. They wait for 6 hours. But then they wanted to look at the physical response to something important for their ecology. So we looked at the shell. You can see here the top is in control condition, the prostate is in 4, the top is CO2. And it wasn't much of a difference. But when it's positive by CO2, you can see this curve again. Through OAIC, I don't believe this curve is going to be going on by the means. But we've never seen any change. Very rarely. We need a very strict OAIC selection. And what is interesting is that the marginal population behave very, very similarly. But the one that suffered most dissolution by CO2 is a living organism able to compensate for mineralization for the loss in shell under low pH condition. But it cannot compensate much. It is the loss is up to 3%. The reviewer is just saying enough. I think in the long term is enough to cause trouble to the individual, to the fitness maybe, through energetics. But can we change something in the population? This is across a lot of individuals. So we're not really looking at the variance. And, please. It's so small that you don't see it. Sometimes they describe you don't see it. I remember that because the regression is made on the average population rather than on the whole data set. But it's incredibly small. So I can tell it's small because, of course, there's some variance on one individual in the same population. But it's different than the different than the country. And it affects most of the populations. And also, we, just to make sure that we could discriminate between the active, this is
the okay.
I think, indicate why strongly that could be a very important mechanism. And also, it's interesting that the geography of the range of population are considered the least adapted by transient emission, the margin there. It's a sort of degradation, dissipation of the presence of buttons. So we know that CO2 may act as an additional mechanism for geographical distribution of heat, like temperature already does. This is called rarefaction. When they become rarer, less strong, less abundant, less fertile. So it was interesting when I had the study that showed this, like, Anna, which is a colleague that was in Sweden, but back in the UK, studying the nice people that live in the Baltic, and also in Stockholm, between different salinity and different spots of CO2. But here, so local additional analogy, this is published in a special issue, we published last year, 2016, in the National Association. Peter Paul, from the Norwegian Polarism, we did a study together on Carpus Glacialis, and we have different populations from the Arctic to show difference, even if they are connected to the currents. The Earth being very slow, transportation very slow. There's no enough to have local adaptation of carbon emissions. At least this is necessary. That's something we want to do. It's always a good work. And finally, when the colleague, Mr. Chairman, we saw the difference along the tolerance gradient in salinity and temperature. We have the northern trip, which is the engine of the economy for us in Canada. It's very important. We're slowing down really badly. Also show different sensitivities to different temperature conditions. So this goes from the basic ecology that we're discussing with the Antonio Whiteboard, the really important Antarctica, but the Copper are really, really important for the Arctic area, together with other crustaceans. So from ecology to the this is a migrant that you know, it's difficult to understand unless you've been there for a while, how in Norway, Norwegian culture, and Swedish culture is still something important. You find it in any other paper. And it's a typical sentence, I don't know if it's crazy. And it's saying, can the country get back in particular and see what important in culture? So, not only we can lose ecosystem function, memory, we can lose our relationships. So the last thing, is that okay? Are you okay? Do you have questions before I move to the third point? This is the last. So is the idea of species, life, can transform, can change, and plasticity and adaptation mean the same thing, changes. The difference is where they happen, when they happen. Plasticity to the individual, season by season, think about grain and migraines, we have to do, I think, 2000 and you believe about one thing to change quickly there, membrane function, and there's a protein to start with, this is crazy. Can adapt. So within a generation, you get adaptation. I'm talking about speciation. We have this idea from Darwin, it's great, but adaptation doesn't have to be speciation. To give an example, in the north coast of Maine, there was a rich community of dust birds present on a rocky source. Study their community, the structure, the shape, the variation in shape of different biomes, different dust birds. Then one day, a storm came. Destroy the coastal bay. And the day after, it went from the week after, and he measured what was left, and he noticed that there was a very strong selection from plain species of some possible, that particularly shaped the haven't observed before. But in order to say 5-6 orders, relationship of height, length, wind, there was one left, or two left, it was the only one that could resist the absolute waves from the selection of distant areas. Relationship to change. I said, well, I'm talking about it, you're not discriminating yet, because you only use, I don't have genetic tools for some stuff, we are developing, etc. But we talk about exposure. So the idea that over generation, when you expose, whether it's selection or motivation, you change. I want to see whether so you have to get buffered with negative effect of some kind. So the question is to see whether exposure of the parents to a condition provide protection to their offspring in general. And that was not the specification only in the first study was not actually about SLE to date of second generation. So we're very pale after we went through the world. And we had to select this, maybe a specific organism. So we use the principle of Blackrock. I would say that the model organism is one of the species that best ecological system to answer a question. And what we did, we selected this work that is very important to know, like one millimeter in the adult. They have a very simple life cycle that we can keep in a lab. Larger, male is vulnerable, and larger, we can say, to touch each other. So I'm
Change in female size, which determines the gametes. We have a significant reduction, which is
the same visualization, because different lines correspond quite differently.
You see, in the case of the average value,
which corresponds again, as I said, to the limit of the dwarfism, the reduction in size, normally due to the change in the shift in the energy margin.
But what is interesting is here that the fecundity here is because you go from the
small event to the last.
You have a massive drop in fecundity. And it's really like a big fraction. You can see the average here is like 700.
That's impressive. Nice years. Wait a second, what is the size of reducing zones? The size of matter. We didn't want to progression, but the body mass is considered individually as an error. And so we can say that yes, it was a significant effect of body mass, but it was marginal compared to the effect of the stress response.
Sorry,
orbit in this case. So it might be a mechanism that we can have rather than modern time to actually understand the alien responses. But we need to keep going back and forth to try to see when there's any part of the energy. The interesting thing is that we can perform under orbit condition and combine more pan to find the parameters of a failure of the collapse at the very beginning of the experiment. We have a very large level of mortality to survive the entropy under combined orbit condition below 50. So this is what is defined as hard selection. And we had extinction of some lineages. So family couldn't manage to reproduce, even if we can give it to the female economic partner. Of course, there was a male issue. Some leaders died into an extinct. They couldn't reproduce. They were still viable, and because at this point, I mean, this is a complete speculation. I discussed with you, please stop me.
Enhorabuena por tu trabajo y tu equipo. Pero yo estoy un poco preocupada porque la mayoría de las especies marinas son de ciclos largos. Son longevas y es decir, no se reproducen con tanta rapidez. Hay algunas que pueden vivir, al menos también, pueden vivir varios años, se reproducen dos veces al año, como mucho. Y esas especies no son capaces muchas veces de reproducirse, porque cuando están estresadas, que obviamente con la acidificación del agua y más con la temperatura, pero está combinado, invierten toda su energía en sobrevivir, esperando que vengan mejores tiempos. Y eso no viene. Y cuando no viene, hay especies que incluso los adultos son capaces de sobrevivir pH muy ácido, como por ejemplo el isopodocea turcatarinata, que vive en el río Odiel, Tinto, y eso está muy acidificado, y no se reproduce. Incluso con Ampelica, el río Corni, que nosotros hemos estado trabajando de poco, Ampelica, así pues, 5 meses cultivándolo y es capaz de completar su ciclo, capaz de crecer, capaz de conseguir la madurez sexual, pero no se reproduce. Y el control sí se reproduce, no hay ningún problema, pero incluso en los pH más suaves es capaz de reproducirse, pero esos juveniles no sobreviven. Entonces, ¿cómo estudiarlo? O sea, ¿cómo le va a afectar a ese la gran mayoría de animales marinos el cambio global, porque no van a ser capaces de realizar muchas generaciones?
Sabine, thank you for a nice talk. One thing that worries me as a biologist is that a lot of the focus is on physiochemical, because of the warming and also the CO2 and gasification, for instance. This is a clear cut link, so it's clear, but for some of these temperatures studies, we have some more difficulties in grasping the relevance. I don't doubt the result and things like that, but even a fairly famous study called Charles Darwin, in his book, he commented on the fact that some of these physiochemical environmental factors like temperature did not have a significant effect on the biogeography of species. And he took garden plants in England as a clear cut example of that, because to say that in the computation and the type of biotic relationships.